Hi there. Let's learn a little bit about how to use a spreadsheet program, Excel, to graph data. In this video, you will learn how to label two columns of data, type XY data into two columns, make an XY scatter plot in Excel, and draw a line of best fit through data with a trend line, and then interpret an R-squared value. First, let's learn how to label columns of data. This is actually quite simple. Just click on a cell in the spreadsheet and type in the label. I will call my X column of values X. Now I will click on the next box over to call that column of data Y. Next, let's type some data into these columns. I will click on the box under X and type in my X-axis value, hit enter, and then repeat for each value. I will then click on the first box under Y and do the same thing for a set of Y values. Now that we have typed our values into the spreadsheet, let's graph these values using an XY scatter plot. First, left click and select all the values in the two columns. Now go to the menu and click Insert. Under Charts, select Scatter, the one without lines connecting the points. Now the data has been plotted. Notice how when I hover the mouse over a data point, its XY values appear. These are the data I have plotted in the shaded columns to the left. Next, let's insert a trend line through this data. Left click on one of the points in the graph. Select Add Trend Line. Notice that a dotted blue trend line has been drawn through the points. Finally, let's have the computer generate the equation for the trend line and report the R-squared value for that line. Click on the trend line. Select Format Trend Line. Under the Format Trend Line menu, click Display Equation on Chart and Display R-squared Value. Now the equation for the trend line is displayed. The equation is y equals 2x. The r-squared value is exactly 1. The r-squared value tells us how well the line drawn fits the data. The closer the r-squared value is to 1, the better the fit. The farther the r-squared value is from 1, the worse the fit. The equation of the line is important in graphical analysis because it allows us to determine the slope of the line and the y-intercept. The slope of the line is 2 in this case. Let's review. In this video, you learned how to label two columns of data, type XY data into two columns, make an XY scatter plot in Excel, draw a line of best fit through data with a trend line, and interpret an R-squared value. In the next videos, we will graph some actual data from a kinetics experiment. We will graph concentration time data, use the R-squared value to determine the order of the chemical reaction, and use the slope of the line of best fit to determine the value of the rate constant K. Thanks for watching.